What is going on, everybody? My name is Nathan Oilmanafrost. Welcome back to another episode review video of The Walking Dead. This one's doing my episode review on The Walking Dead Season 5, Episode 10, entitled Them. Now, this aired last night, guys, Sunday, February the 15th, on AMC. It was a very, very good episode, as usual. I mean, honestly, there's not really anything else to say but that, you know, this show is just unbelievable. It's above other shows out there in so many different ways that it is just, it's kind of become unreal. You know what I mean? I don't know exactly when the show's going to end. I don't know. I don't see it ending anytime soon, really, at all. Breaking Bad ended in season 5. That's a show that you can put an end to. But The Walking Dead, there's no sufiable end. It's a zombie apocalypse. Do you know what I mean? Like, it's not going to just be like, you know, Rick goes to jail or, you know, something like that, or, you know, Rick dies, the whole show ends. It's not just about Rick. It's not just about one character. It's about a group. It's about humanity in its own. So I really don't see that happening anytime soon, but that's just my opinion on it. You know what I mean? Like, this could go so far down the line, it would be unreal. So anyways, now into the episode review video, just to let you guys know, there's our obviously spoilers in this video. I can't really review an episode of The Walking Dead without, you know, spoiling something. So if you guys don't like spoilers, maybe you guys haven't watched the episode yet, definitely go check it out first, and then come back here and listen to my review. Simple as that. So let's get into it now. The synopsis of this episode was, life on the road has left the group beaten and beleaguered. Will they be able to trudge along? Are they even the same people they once were? So basically, in my prediction video, I made a few predictions that actually turned out to be true, and I'm very, very happy that they actually did turn out to be true, because the predictions I made weren't just predictions that I thought were going to happen. They were also predictions and thoughts on what I think should happen and what's going to happen. So basically, when I predicted that at the end of the episode, this episode, that we would see the introduction of a character. I didn't say that it would be this episode, but I said it would be very, very soon. It could be at the end of this episode, might be at the starting of next episode. But nonetheless, we finally get to meet him, guys. And I'm talking about Aaron. But before we get into that, I will go briefly through the episode and everything like that. So hopefully you guys do enjoy the gameplay in the background. This is actually Call of Duty Ghost on the PS4. I actually bought it recently, turning in some old games. This is Call of Duty Ghost. I'm playing some Extinction. Hopefully you guys enjoy this gameplay. It's like an alien survival mode type thing. It is a lot of fun, so I do recommend you guys try it out if you guys want to play Call of Duty Ghost with me and play Extinction or just online in general. I also have that game now, so you can definitely hit me up on PSN with that. But now going into the Walking Dead review video for Season 5, Episode 10, Them. Okay, so survivors, they're on the road to Washington, D.C., okay? At the starting of the episode, basically, it's sort of them sort of gathering their bearings, looking for food, scavenging, you know, stuff like that. They're kind of stopped on the road, sort of. And, you know, they're looking for water, supplies, everything like this. And, needless to say, they don't find any. So, also, Maggie is sobbing, in the woods. She's sitting beside a tree. A walker approaches. You know, she gets up, stops crying, kills the walker, kind of continues on her way. Obviously, she's feeling for Beth, you know, the loss of her sister. The loss of her father is still probably lingering back there in her mind somewhat. Anyways, now moving on to Daryl. He finds a worm buried in the dirt and eats it. We've seen Daryl eat plenty of things on The Walking Dead. We actually seen him eat rattlesnakes. We've seen him eat, you know, squirrels. Just tons of stuff. Tons of stuff that you would normally not eat. But obviously, it's not going to be that bad for you. You know what I mean? Worms are actually full of protein. You know, you can actually get a lot of protein. You can actually survive on eating worms. Personally, I wouldn't, you know, it's not my choice. But if there was a zombie apocalypse and, you know, you were starving, you know, I think you'd pretty much eat anything. You know, people even resorted to cannibalism. You know what I mean? Like, there was the Terminans. They even resorted to cannibalism. Again, personally, I wouldn't do that. I wouldn't do cannibalism personally, but anything else I would be completely open to. If it depends on you surviving and living on, or you just dying quietly in a corner, just starving to death, that would be the worst way to go. You know what I mean? You got to go down swinging. You got to go down fighting. And just to make yourself starve to death because you're not wanting to eat something that you're not used to eating would kind of be a dumb way to go out. So Daryl, Maggie, and Sasha return to the road empty-handed. The rest of the group sits around a van, exhausted and dehydrated, and obviously hungry, and they didn't find anything either. So now, back on the road, the survivors' vans run out of gas. They're forced to continue on foot. Daryl notes that Judith is hungry and decides to go foraging in the woods. Carol goes after him. Well, doesn't really go after him, but goes with him, rather. Carl gives Maggie a jewelry box that he found while scavenging. Gabriel walks with Maggie and offers, wow, I don't know why I stuttered there. He's offering basically his help, in a way, you know what I mean? Like, he's offering Maggie, you know, he sees that she's upset. And at the same time, throughout this episode, he's becoming less and less religious as the episode goes on. He becomes less and less dependent on God. He's shitting his clothes. You know, he got rid of the jacket before the episode even started. So already we're starting to see him decay from priest mode, I guess is what you could call it. Which I found pretty cool. You know, obviously you can't be... I mean, yeah, there does have to be some sort of hope in it. But they can't have a character being able to survive just by being a priest. You know what I mean? Like... the things you have to do now, basically, in this world, in order to survive, you've got to do. You know, you can't just be a priest and be full of hope for everyone. It's not going to work, and eventually you would die. So that's what he's kind of realizing now. Like he needs to start shedding and getting away from that past. Even though he is religious, and even though you know he's a priest, he loves God. You know, whatever. He realizes that. Like God's being brutal, you know what I mean? Like, in aspect of him, obviously, God's being brutal at this point. He doesn't know exactly what to do. He doesn't know whether to put faith in God at the same time because of everything that's going on around him. And he's sort of just, like I said, he's shitting away from his past. So anyways, Carl gives Maggie a jewelry box. Like I said, Gabriel kind of walks with Maggie, offers, to discuss her grief over Beth and her father. She basically shuts him down by saying, "You never even met them." And then she basically snaps, reminding Gabriel of his choices in letting his congregants die. Remember back when he basically said that, you know, he locked his people out of his church when they were screaming for help. You know, he closed the doors at night. He didn't open them up. So he does have some sin. He does have some blood on his hands in a way. I wouldn't really see it like that personally, but, you know, Maggie might, obviously, or else she's just probably really pissed off and just sad at this point. She doesn't want to be bothered. Sasha, she was very, very angry throughout this entire episode, and angry makes you stupid, as Michonne says, and, that's what it made Sasha in this episode. Now, don't get me wrong, there was no character deaths whatsoever in this episode. There was no characters from our main cast, the main cast of the show. There was no characters like that at all that died during this episode. I'm very relieved from that. Obviously, the last two episodes, episode 8, Coda, and episode 9, what happened and what's going on. You know, we had two major deaths there. We had Beth and Coda. And then we had Tyrese in What Happened and What's Going On. We had both of those character deaths, and those were obviously from our main cast. So I'm really glad they sort of, you know, got away from that in a way, and stopped doing the constant character deaths, because we would run out of characters if they kept doing it. So I'm glad no one died during this episode, needless to say. So, anyways, Sasha, like I said, she is very, very angry. She eyes a walker herd trailing the group at a distance. She suggests to Michonne that they can take the dead down. This was actually in the sneak peek that AMC offered last week on the YouTube channel and on the website and everything like that. She suggests to Michonne that she can take the dead down, basically, and Michonne says that they wouldn't waste their energy. And she tells Sasha, you know, your brother, he was angry, and anger made him stupid. And that's the same thing that's happening to Sasha. So Sasha angrily marches off, basically. So, meanwhile, in the woods, Carol gives Daryl a knife that once belonged to Beth, and she kind of urges him to let himself grieve, you know what I mean? Let himself feel it, because he hasn't really ever since Beth died, he hasn't really sat down and, had himself a good cry. You know what I mean? He's kind of having it all bundled up. That's kind of his way of keeping it together for the group, if you know what I mean. So back on the road now, Rick and the others lure the walker herd over the edge of a steep embankment. Basically, that herd that was following them, Rick finally made the decision to turn around, and there was sort of a bridge sort of thing, and they kept leading the walkers off the bridge, not really fighting them, not really, doing anything to them, not killing them, just literally stepping out of the way at the last second and letting them fall off sort of a cliff, sort of. So yeah, that's what they do. That's what they were doing. They were trying to just, get them to stop following them and save as much energy as they had as possible. So Sasha now impatiently stabs a walker in the head, sparking a full-fledged assault. So anger makes you stupid. You damn fucking right they do. So they had this plan and strategy to just, like I said, lead the walkers off, not get bundled up, not let the walkers fall on the ground so that the walkers would, stumble and fall, and this whole thing would just go awry, basically. And that's what happened when Sasha took it upon herself to start killing them instead. So, her doing this, obviously it didn't really anger the walkers. It just it caused like a full-fledged assault, basically. The group kills all the walkers, and Michonne basically not really punishes Sasha, but like, I told you not to do that. Rick actually almost got bit because of it. His arm was very, very close to getting bit by a walker, and Daryl at the last second came up behind the walker, pulled him off Rick, and obviously threw him over the bank. So yeah, a lot of things almost happened, and Abraham was actually, this is something I noticed, Abraham was stabbing a zombie, and Sasha was actually slicing at a zombie at the same time, and she sliced the zombie, but at the same time sliced his arm. It wasn't a very deep cut or anything like that, but still, it's reckless, it's careless, and it's not good for the group at this point. She's got to stop being so damn angry. She's jeopardizing the group's safety to basically satisfy her anger, and that's not tolerable. So down the road, the group comes across a cluster of abandoned cars. Daryl heads back into the woods as the group investigates. Maggie opens a car trunk and finds a female walker bound and gagged inside. This sort of reminded her, this is what I got from Lauren Cohen on Talking Dead, this sort of reminded her of Beth in a way, because this walker was blonde. She kind of looked innocent. Obviously, it was a kidnapped walker. Her arms were tied behind her back. Obviously, her, she was bound and gagged and everything like that. And it was sort of innocent, you know what I mean? Like, she didn't die, right. She was totally innocent. She didn't have a fighting chance or anything like that. And that was sort of Maggie's way of kind of coping with the loss of Beth in a way. She kind of slams the door of the trunk closed and then tries to open it back up. She gets frustrated. Glenn basically comes over. He opens the trunk, stabs the walker, and he says, "Let's go." So as the group settles by the roadside for the night, a pack of feral dogs, which I thought was pretty cool. I at first thought it was like a new group with like a pack of dogs like leading them, but it was actually just dogs. It was sort of a wild aspect to the show. You know what I mean? Like, we've seen Rick's group fight, human beings, people that were trying to kill them and everything like that. And I'm sure the dogs would have done the same thing, but this was sort of like a creature, an animal versus animal sort of battle. You know what I mean? And Sasha at the last second, like Rick was getting his machete ready, Daryl had his knife out, and Sasha just picks up an assault rifle and guns down all the dogs. So needless to say, they ended up eating dogs for lunch or dinner or whatever you want to call it, just for food, survival food. I honestly, I'm totally against, people eating dogs, but it's not out of my way. You know what I mean? Like, I don't really care personally, and I wouldn't eat my own dogs. This is just how I think too. Don't think I'm pushing it on anybody else. This is the way I think. You know what I mean? People eat cows, people eat pigs, people eat tons and tons of things. There's so many things out there that people eat, and I just think it's kind of dumb to restrict eating of an animal to one specific species. You know what I mean? Like, if you're going to eat a cow, if you're going to eat a pig and have a clean conscience about it, then you shouldn't be pissed off at somebody for eating dog. Do you know what I mean? Like, I'm just trying to, it's my way of sort of rationalizing it. It's not really rationalizing it. It's just, it's kind of hard to explain. It's just, you know, it's my way of kind of not really caring in a way. You know, believe me, I like dogs. I have, you know, a few dogs of my own, actually, Chihuahuas. But what I'm saying is, like, you shouldn't just restrict to eating one species and, you know, hating everybody else who eats another species. Because, you know, cultures are different and, you know, stuff like that. And as far as the zombie apocalypse goes, you're fucking right, I'd eat a dog. You know what I mean? Like, if I was starving, of course. It's survival of the fittest in a way. You know what I mean? It's just, it's the way you gotta live. So, anyway, so yeah, Sasha shoots them dead. Later, the group mindlessly chews on the dog meat around a campfire. Noah tells Sasha that Tyrese tried to help him. He's not sure that he can survive. And then Sasha basically says, if you're not sure that you won't survive, then you won't. The group continues eating. Gabriel removes his collar from his shirt, kind of throws it in the fire. Again, this is another way of Gabriel sort of like shedding his past, shedding him being a priest and everything like that. He's getting rid of things constantly. Like, he unbuttoned his shirt, you know, he got rid of his jacket. Now he's throwing the collar, tossing it in his fire. The next day, Maggie tells Glenn that in the wake of Beth's death, that she's not sure that she wants to keep going. Glenn basically says, you know, we fought to be here, and we have to keep fighting. You know, this is how we survive, basically. Abraham now offers Sasha a sip of liquor from the bottle. He basically says that you're with friends, and she fires back with, we're not friends. I'd be like, all right, bitch, fine. I don't know why she's so full of hatred. I get that she's angry, but she shouldn't be angry towards the rest of the group that's only trying to do good by her. Again, anger makes you stupid. Yeah, so Daryl heads into the woods again. He actually spots a barn in the distance and stakes it out. He likes a cigarette. And this is where I sort of see this happening. He lights a cigarette, and he stubs it out on his hand, basically. You know, he's putting the cigarette out on his hand. And this is the way of him trying to feel pain. You know what I mean? Like, he's had this bundled up inside of him. He's sitting here trying to feel pain, and it doesn't look like it's working at first. You know, he doesn't do anything. He doesn't cry. He doesn't do anything. He's stubbing the cigarette on his hand, and then he finally breaks down in tears. And this is a way of letting it all go, in a way. The group comes across a collection of water bottles in the middle of the road, guys. This was pretty strange. There's a note that reads, from a friend. As they debate the possibility that the water is a trap, Eugene grabs a bottle and starts to drink, or tries to drink, rather. Abraham slaps it out of his hand. This is in a way, you know, they're thinking maybe it's a trap from somebody. You know, the water can be poisoned, and Eugene kind of wants to pay back in a way. You know, obviously he did a shitty thing by saying, you know, he has a cure for the zombie apocalypse, everything like that. And this is the way he kind of wants to get even with himself in a way. You know, he wants to take one for the team, see if it's all right to drink, and Abraham immediately slaps it out of his hand. Thunder sounds, and then rain starts pouring from the sky. Everyone's laughing, playing around. They drink the water, not the water that was in the bottles or anything, with the note that said, you know, from a friend, which again, we'll learn more about that friend here in a little bit. Friend by the name of Aaron. Daryl tells Rick that there's a barn nearby. You know, they need to get shelter from the storm. The group secures the barn and settles in for the night. And this is where, this is where everything really got kind of epic. This was a scene straight out of the comic book, and it was very, very cool. So Rick, Daryl, Glenn, and Carol sit around a fire. Rick recalls a story for his grandfather. This is something that we don't really see from Rick too much. He doesn't really get into his personal life at all. He doesn't ever bring it up too much. But here he tells a story. He says that his grandfather survived World War II. Everything like that. And it's just kind of his way of relating to the current world of a zombie apocalypse. You know, he basically says that his grandfather fought in World War II, and, you know, he says that every morning he got up saying, "Rest in peace, let's go to war." Basically assuming every single day that he would die that day just by fighting the war. And at the end, he got out of it alive. So that's how he's relating to it. He says that this is how we survive. We do what we have to do, and then we get to live. He says this is how we survive, and then at the end, he says we tell ourselves that we are the Walking Dead. Oh my God, it was so fucking cool. I loved every part of that speech. That was a very, very iconic speech in the comic book by saying, "We are the Walking Dead," basically saying that, you know, we're sort of like the walkers, but obviously we're not dead. It's just, you know, it's a matter of time, in a way. You know what I mean? Like, we're already dead, and we're fighting in order to live at the end. You know what I mean? Like, that's what he's kind of referring to. And Daryl tells Rick that we ain't them. This is where the episode comes from. He says, "We ain't them," you know, basically referring to the walkers. We're not dead yet. It's not gonna happen. Rick basically assures him, and he says, "You know, we're not them." And that basically urges the group to keep fighting on. This gives them kind of a new purpose. And that's why Rick is a fucking motivational speaker in a way. You know what I mean? He reinvents the group every single time people feel down. And he gives them something to fight for just by literally telling a personal story of his own. Later that night, Daryl's keeping watch while the group sleeps. He secures the barn doors. He spots a herd of walkers approaching outside. He barricades the doors with his body. As the walkers pile up, the others rush basically to go to the door and kind of counterweight the weight of the walkers that are pushing against it. There's a tornado or a hurricane or whatever outside of the barn and everything like that. The next morning, Maggie wakes up in Glenn's arms. The storm has passed, the sun is shining. She relives basically, or doesn't really relive, like relieves rather. Daryl, and she basically says that, you know, you can rest now. You don't have to sit here. You don't have to, you know, you don't have to keep watch anymore. You know, you can basically, you can go get some rest. You can get some sleep. She wakes up Sasha, knowing that she is mad, and so is Sasha. She knows that she's angry, and so is Maggie. Maggie is full of anger because of the loss of Beth and her father. You know, she's full of anger and sadness, and Sasha is just full of anger and hatred and everything like this. So, like, she wakes Sasha, and they walk outside, and they find mangled walkers, which is actually a pretty cool scene. The tornado must have hit just shy of their barn, which is why the barn didn't get taken down. But there was a bunch of trees, obviously, down. You know, wood going through walkers. The walkers were everywhere. Body parts fucking everywhere. It was pretty cool. It's a pretty cool scene. I like it. Anyways, Sasha says that it should have torn us apart, basically wondering that the tornado didn't fucking take the barn, you know, why it spared the barn, basically. They watch the sun rise over a field. They go out to a field, and Sasha basically says, "You know, why are we out here?" And Maggie looks at the sunset and basically, or not the sunset, I guess, the sunrise. In a beautiful, beautiful field. It was very, very pretty. It was very, very cool. You know, they kind of watch it, and she basically says, "You know, this is why we're out here." And cut to why I was talking about Aaron and this new character that has been introduced. A man suddenly approaches with his hands raised. He introduces himself as Aaron. Maggie and Sasha get up, point their guns at him. You know, "Who are you? What do you want?" Aaron basically says that, "I have good news. I need to speak to the person in charge." And that is when the episode cuts. Now, spoilers, guys. Spoilers, spoilers, spoilers. Aaron is a scout from the Alexandria Safe Zone, and I'm very, very excited for what happens next. Last week's episode prediction video for this week's episode of The Walking Dead. I basically predicted that we would get to see Aaron very soon. If not this episode, it would be next episode, but we get to see Aaron now. You know, he's already scouting the group. He knows the leader's name is Rick. He already knows that. He's been watching them. He basically says that I'm a friend and I have good news, which again relates to the fact that he's the one who left the water bottles and everything like that in the center of the road for Rick's group. That, said from a friend. He left the water bottles from him. Obviously, they didn't end up drinking them because, they probably thought that it was going to be like a trap or whatever. But nonetheless, that's that, guys. Aaron is now a part of this, and there was a sneak peek leading into next week's episode of The Walking Dead, a promo, everything like that. I will get into that on my prediction video, which again goes up this Thursday on my channel, which will be February the 19th. My prediction video for this week's upcoming episode of The Walking Dead, Season 5, Episode 11, entitled The Distance. So yeah, I'm very, very excited for it. Hopefully you guys are too. Definitely check back on Thursday for my prediction video. Hopefully you guys did enjoy this week's episode review video of The Walking Dead Season 5, Episode 10, Them. And if you did, feel free to hit the video with a like, share it with your friends, tell me in the comment section below what else you guys want to see from me. And let me know also in the comment section what you guys thought of the episode. Have a little discussion down there with yourselves. Just, go back and forth. Tell me what you guys thought. I'll have a little discussion with you. And that's pretty much it. So, yeah, talk to you guys later.